Everybody, thanks for joining me on my channel. My name is Philip, and we're going to play some Spelunky. So I've been playing this game for probably about 200 hours over the course of its time on PS3, PS4, and PC. That's not to say I'm any good at it. But I've beaten it a couple times, maybe 5 or 6 times. Never passed hell, so hoping to change that sometime soon. Although I like to have no stakes, low intensity runs. I like to collect bit of money as I go, just so I don't get forced into being a terrorist in order to make it to the City of Gold. Pick up the damsel. Got the damsels on random. So, I like to have a bit of variety between the damsel, male and female, and the dog. Out of here with just under 15k, that's not bad. 5 health and an extra couple of bombs. That's a good first level. And a snake pit, so I know from experience we're guaranteed a pick or a metok. That's our exit secured. Yeah, I like the looks of that shop. Straight away, just to avoid having to come back down that same way in case we run out of time. Don't want to be dodging ghosts to get her. Obviously didn't need that rope, considering I ended up getting the gloves. That's okay, it's not too much of a waste either. Slightly tempted to close the vault, but it's not necessary at the moment, and like I said, I like it to be low intensity, so just gonna carry on. GoldenEye wasn't in this level, so got plenty of plenty of money. 30k, nice couple of items. Doing really well. Really trying to set off that explosive without killing myself. It's okay, there's nothing important there. It's just a small bit of a waste, that's all. And there's the key. So just need to find where the chest is. Sloppy. Why are these boxes? They're not. There we go. That took a lot more effort than it should have. Usually they go off if you sneeze in their direction. Let's have a quick look down here. Can't see it, but there is an idol. Sorry, you might hear my son in the background. He's currently on his school holidays, so. Yeah. Oh, that was silly. There's our box anyway. That and I can see if there's any gems around while I'm looking around. The golden eye gives you the same ability as the glasses to see into the rock and see if there's any hidden treasures, which is awesome. And it looks like we won't be branded a terrorist for taking this. The skull wasn't exactly what I had in mind. I'm going to take this out and a lot of gold here, but oh, I'm really surprised I survived that. I was genuinely sure that was instant death. I wasn't expecting to get caught in the spider web. Not sure if being bounced into the spider web is what saved me, or if maybe that just does less damage than I was aware of. That's funny though. Oh dear. Okay, let's run one down. Let's try again. As with many roguelikes, just trying to get used to not having some of the items from the last run, like the climbing gloves. Expecting to stick to the walls can sometimes get you in a bit of trouble. Very sloppy. And I easily could have lost the damsel there as well. Some spikes or something, but luckily there was none there. So, on the lookout again for the key in the chest. Side, so I don't have to go bombing my way into there. Actually, I might do. Yeah, I do, yeah. Right. Don't want to set off the terror alarm. So I'll come down this side. So should have squeezed over the top, which is what I had intended to do, but just in case we need the next level. One. It's the Eye of Ra. Definitely take the visit to the shopkeeper. Risking going around the bottom there. Two ropes. That should be alright. Setting myself up to get the golden skull, if I can do it without angering the shopkeeper. So we'll take ourselves a little escape route here. And if I'm quick enough with this, shopkeeper won't even notice. So that's great. 30 grand going into the fourth mine. Okay. Now luckily we picked up the glasses, and one of the bonuses the glasses has is that you get a nice radius in the dark, even if I didn't have the torch. I'll keep the torch just for lighting the lamps. Gets you a little bit of extra gold. And I guess you sort of spider webs faster and things. And we will take our time for the most part. Because we definitely don't want to set off any traps or. Now, I'm not a fan of the torch. It does definitely have some advantages. Like its advantage, you know, its ability to kill bats instantly is quite nice. They're a bit of a pain. stuns the ghost for a millisecond. And quite a cute animation. They blush that you're taking a picture of them and freeze for a second. For the ink and not have to go full black market terrorist, which just adds an extra layer of stress to going through hell in that. I want to spare the not sure I want to spare the bombs on finding him. Oh, there's a few spiders there. Aha, we don't have to. For the camera. Not a massive fan of the camera in the first place. Sorry if there's any rustling there. Hope it doesn't sound too bad. My beard rubbing against the microphone. It's a new microphone, so I'm not used to its range and that. Just keeping an eye out for our radar, as we definitely want the black market, not just for the ank, which is that was a lot more anxiety filled than it needed to be. The ank, which is our key to getting into the city of gold and then hell. Oh no! Jump, 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 jump! Okay. Jesus. Oh man. There's definitely a level of performance anxiety. Silliest little ways that I normally wouldn't. But like I said at the start, I'm not that good. But I am usually careful. Rushing water, so. That means extra ponds and fish, and I can't remember the name of the fish at the end of the level. Old Bitey, yeah. I only killed him the once when I had an absolute multitude of bombs to chuck down there. And we're one for one. He's killed me once and I've killed him once. Well, that was very, very silly and very, very unnecessary. Ah, blip. So I'm hoping it's not too close to the vault. The blipping has stopped. Because like I said, I'm not too... Oh my god, that's me dead. Okay, I'm going to call it there for episode one. And get myself a cup of tea, take a breath before we try.